Hello there, Internet. Welcome back to Project Playground. You will die again, or you will die again, Project Playground. When we last left off, we were going to start working on Tinker's Construct. And there's a couple things I need. I need this. And I need a furnace. So we'll take this furnace with us. There we go. Gotta get the other part. There we go. Basically what I'm doing is as I'm mining, I'm creating these squares, and as you go down, you can see I just keep creating square after square after square. That's how I've been getting my mining up. Yay! Because you do get a mining experience in the Neverminds mod too, so it's pretty cool. So we just basically left off where we stopped at. Excuse me for one moment while I kill this goblin. How did you hit me? There we go. This is going to be one of those projects that I'm probably just going to have to, like, do and then show. Basically, what's going to happen here is stone is going to go all the way up. And then on the inside, we'll have, like, a wood wall with beams. And the reason why is because I want to use paint from the paint machine from, I think, Open Blocks. And the only way to do that is to have a actual the vanilla Minecraft blocks have to be used. You can't use anything else, as I've learned in my previous playthroughs of using open blocks. So we're just gonna set this on top like this. We're gonna put that in there, and now the way we're gonna start off making our forge is getting the seared bricks. So you can do it like this and get grout. Excuse me while we take a nap real quick, because, you know, it's night. I could sleep in my bed. I should sleep in my bed. I'm so used to grabbing the sleeping bag the moment I hear that noise. I should, yeah, definitely. So you can do it like this, or you can take individual pieces and get like this, I believe. You get two. Now, if we take this and we go like this, I believe we get more, if I remember. Nope. Okay, I lied. Obviously, I lied. I lied a lot. Okay. So now I have to break 32 blocks of this stuff. Wonderful. You're so smart. Ugh. Okay, I'll do that off camera. Because this is actually going to be one of those things that you have to do necessary to get what you need. And sorry, I changed a couple of my key bindings, so it's a little weird. So what we get out of that is basically grout, and then from the grout we just put it in here. And for now, let's see, do we have anything here? No. So for now we'll put all this in here where it's safe. I was working on getting some doors made earlier, so that will be out of the way. Put this wood in there too. I died. And then we're gonna get seared brick. Now, where to put this thing is gonna be the next question. So this is gonna be the main hub area, the main road area. So I want it to be seeable. So I'm guessing maybe right here would probably do. I should probably go fix this shovel too. I'm gonna probably need it. I kinda feel bad for using this iron for a door. Uh oh, I heard a ghost. But I kinda need it to keep the villagers out. I don't like being down here because all I hear are monsters constantly, and it's kind of annoying as hell. I need to fix this. There we go. Alright, and I don't think I have enough iron. Because I need, what, 4 iron blocks, right? Oh yeah, I got plenty of iron, okay. Let's get that smelting while we're waiting. Because we'll actually... Oh, do I have obsidian? Do I need obsidian? I can't remember. Oh no. I don't remember. Tool forge. I do need obsidian. Oh boy, that's going to be a difficult one. I can make a diamond pickaxe too, so... Oh man, there's so much stuff I'm going to have to be doing here. Seriously, you weren't here before. Shoot each other. Thanks. Did you kill each other? Oh god. Sand Golem. Come here. Fight me. Oh god. Oh. Oh. Shit. There we go. Look at me. 100 health. Ridiculous amount. Look at all the... Ooh, there's a ghost. Come here. Come on, fight me. Fight me. Ow. Not like that. Oh, you're stuck. Good. Stay like that. Thank you. No, I saw you. Ugh. You guys need to go away. They don't have very good mechanics when it comes down to corners. So that's good. Put that back. Alright, because I can't stand this freaking noise they make. And they're gonna spawn in light level 11 or higher if you're using the Nevermind one. Oh god, there was a whole bunch of them. Nevermind. Mm-mm. Nope. Okay. And I need some wood. Do I have any? Yeah, here we go. Need some stick to be more exact. For the pickaxe, that is. Okay, we need to get out of here because that noise is annoying. And I'll get into the bags here shortly because I do need to get a piece of gear or a suit on. I'll get it out in a minute. A suit on that can actually do some help me do some damage. Alright, so we're good there. How's this cooking? This is cooking good. And I need obsidian. I got lava. I just need to make an iron. So much stuff to do before you do anything. Let me get something to eat. There we go. Alright, do I have the extra iron in here? Yes. So we need to make a bucket. Ugh. I don't think I can make the bucket in here. I have to do it upstairs. Alright. So I need to make a bucket to get lava, then lava to get the tool forge. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, but that's not important right now. Ugh. Come on. Seriously. Give me a break. Ugh. I'll be so happy when I have the thing up. Oh, god, you scared the shit out of me. It's really late at night, so it's kind of like really spooky. I keep hearing those damn clowns. And I don't know where they're at. Alright. Anyways. So I'm going to put the tool forge right here. Now the tool forge requires a 3x3 area. So I want the tool forge to be part of the building. Right? So let's see. We got 1, 2. Oh. I'm going to count the ground. Because that's a little too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3. Then you go 1, 2, 3. So we're going to be off by 1. I can live with that. So you need... There's no cave around here. Alright, so there's our 3x3 that we need. Alright, now we'll just simply take this out. Because this will be the wall. Don't make me have to come down there, clown. I'll kill you. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Actually, I didn't even know there was... Is that just, like, solid wood? Huh. Odd. Alright, break that one, and break that one. Alright, that should work. Alright, so there's our hole. We can go ahead and break these, because we don't need it here. Oh, no, I don't want to do that. I want to put... Where did the food go? Did I not pick up the food? Wasn't there watermelon in there? I could have sworn I had watermelon. I saw a watermelon. Am I nuts? Did the watermelon just disappear? Oh, it went in there. Okay. Oh, I had food in there. That's right. There we go. Okay. Now that that's out of the way. Alright. Here's the bricks. Ooh, how's the bricks coming? Coming good. Just a real pain in the ass to do. Let's see. What else can we do beforehand? put that back for now. Let's see. Really nothing. I have to sit here and wait for the seared brick. Let's see. This would give us... Oh my god. Okay, that was really loud. Sorry about that. Let's dump that. Dump that in there. Give me this back, please. Gracias, amigo. Just dump all that in there for now. Let's make our diamond pickaxe for later uses. Usage. Oh yeah. Time to mine and getting upgrade all in one. How cool. So clever. Alright, now to make the seared bricks we need. As you can see, this is called a seared brick, and this is a seared bricks. You need 4. Alright, so now that you know that, let's break these up. It's gonna only give us 10. Okay, whew, it only gives us 10. I thought it bugged out there for a minute. Like, oh my god. So we need, I think, let's see, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, just to get a small forge going, which is fine. Kind of what we want, so my shovel's been repaired, so really quick, let me do this so that way we can get some more seared brick going. So how's your day been? I kind of screwed up in the last episode and put these together, and I really shouldn't, but I could have sworn you could use it seared. I don't even know how to spell. Seared. I could have sworn we could have used it. No, I need grout, not seared. Damn it. Grout. Oh! Okay. So we need the block, and we could get 8. So I don't know if this is... So 3... And that's 4, plus the 1 clay would give us 8, versus the 2 here. So I really think the regular balls was probably the best bet, anyways. Go to sleep. I hate those clowns. I really hate those clowns. If you haven't noticed, I personally want to kill them continuously. They drop some good stuff, though. They drop, like... yellow bag sometimes? Which is pretty nice. Pretty damn nice. Alright, so we got all that picked up, thankfully. Throw that back up there. Now, I did receive a new book. This book is called The Mighty Smell Tree. Now, if you open the smell tree, it'll basically give you everything, all the instructions that I'm telling you now. Okay? And as you can see, these are the items that we need later on. Fair warning, you do not create these with seared bricks. You create them with the regular brick. Okay, that's kind of the reason why I wanted to get some more grout going. We're going to need it for later on. So, if you hear some squealing, that's a dog dreaming. Yes, dogs dream. Amazing, isn't it? Alright, so that's going to be going for our later use. But as you upgrade, you'll be able to get more. So we needed 15, didn't we? I think that's what we needed. Something like that. Boom. 16. Alright, so to make your Tinker's Construct Forge, you just need a 3x3 in the ground. Or you can have it on top, whatever the case may be. Some people like having it up top, some people like having it on the floor. I personally like having them in the floor. So that way if I need to build down, I can just cut the floor out, go down instead of up, and it looked terrible. But you can go, the higher the sides are, like right here, the higher the sides are, the more you can put in. And it'll be shown here in just a second. Oh, I need some more. But as you can see, you don't need the corners. Just as long as these two right here connect, you're fine. So again, you need clay, gravel, and sand to create grout. Then grout you cook and you get seared brick. And then from seared brick, you just make seared bricks with an S, see? It can also be used as a decoration item, too. So, we need one more. Actually, no, we need three more, don't we? Yeah, we need three more, because we're going to attach... This wall will be all smeltery. Hopefully. Uh-oh, wrong one. So this once you get it set up, it's pretty much self-explanatory. Because what'll happen is we'll have, actually, I need to put the tank and the thing out here, don't I? Yeah, I do. So I don't need this out here. You need a smeltery controller and a tank. So we don't need that there. We just need these here. Like this. There we go. So the controller where you dump the iron or the gold or whatever will be out here, and then you can do all your smelting or pouring stuff or castings in here. So you're literally protected no matter which way you go around. How are the villagers, by the way? Are they still alive? Are they still, like, humping the fence post over there? Yep. Oh my god, you're so fast. God damn it, you're so fast. Oh my god, they're quick. They're withers. Oh god, they're so fast. Please hit them, please hit them, please hit them. Oh my goodness. That's one down. Come on, die, 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 die before I die. Thank you. Oh my goodness, that scared me. Damn it, I hate this. I've made this so difficult. Oh, spooky. Okay, so they're all still here. Whew, you dropped an iron chest plate. How's my iron chest plate doing? Protection 2. Protection 2, soulbound. Ooh. Protection 2, soulbound. I'll leave it alone. We'll leave it alone for now. Yes, for now, that is. You can actually make different armors with the mod pack I have. By the way, most of about every one of the mods that I'm using is probably going to be in the description. So loud. In the description down below, so please go check out the description to see all the mods that I'm using. And again, this is a private mod pack. This is not distributed publicly, so if you're looking for it, you're not going to find it on the Feed the Beast launcher or anything like that. So, technically, we can actually go ahead and start our smeltery, and I can show you how to make some of the stuff. This would be cool. So this is a casting base. We need the casting base to make, like, iron blocks and stuff. So we need that. And, it's going to be slow grind. And, again, I have, like, thermal expansion, but I don't have the technology to, or the resources right now, to get the ore I need, because I'm going to be using this. Now, there is something else I'd like to show you while we're doing this. It's the Ender IO, and it is called, where is it at? Is it this, you can get the Sterling Generator. But see, the thing is it requires redstone, so I'm not at redstone yet. To give you power, and it burns like coal, and it'll give you power to power, say, like the seg mill, which, if you hold down shift, it says grinds ore and other items, and grinding balls to increase output efficiency, upgrade capacities to increase speed and energy. What this thing does is it will grind down the actual raw ore into two, or into iron or into dust, and then you take the alloy smelter, which again is a lot of iron here, but the alloy smelter, you can smelt almost anything and it'll go super fast, especially if you have a powered Sterling generator. But you can get all this in the Ender IO, so that is pretty cool. You can also get a survival generator from, is it Open Blocks? I can't remember. Survival? Yeah, Survival Generator. Ooh, that's pretty. But again, you need redstone, so you're kind of stuck with the furnace for a little while. But I've used all of them before, And I have to say, the Ender IO's generator seems to work a lot better. So, I have to say that for sure. Alright, so we need the controller, which is this, or, yeah, spell tree controller, thank you. We also need the tank, which I need a piece of glass for, which I don't have, as usual. Didn't come prepared. I believe it goes around like this. And then, come on, baby. Alright, there's our glass. We can go ahead and put the grout back in. The glass in the middle. That creates our seared tank. Okay. And the basin, I need 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need 7 of these. So we can actually go ahead and demonstrate how you can tell if you've done everything right. So let's just say this isn't here, okay? You have a single layer on your smell tree, alright? Remember, you don't have the corners only need to be connected right here, okay? So that we're clear about that. All you have to do now is place wherever you want your controller. So I'm actually going to put the controller here, and you put your tank anywhere, as long as it's beside the controller, and it's within the 3-block radius. You see, if you put it on the outside, it doesn't really do anything. Have that back, thank you. We put it here, see how this turned on? This means it's now actually ready to take items. However, we need lava to put in here so that it will smelt whatever we put here. So, and also note that if monsters get in here, you will get blood. And there's actually something for blood as well. Oops. There we go. You can have, where's that? Where are you? Tinker's Construct, here we go. You have coagulated blood. You can do the coagulated blood drops. Mostly decoration, but it does damage. So just beware that if you don't put at least 2 high where your villagers or people can jump in here, they will wind up dead. Also, a note that a lot of people don't know about, and there's a hair on my screen I never saw, that if you have a village spawning system where the villagers fall into Tinker's Construct's forge here, they actually will die and produce emeralds, which is pretty cool. The emerald liquid down. And this is where the basin comes into play, where you can actually use the basin to pour an emerald block and then just take the emerald block and break it down in your inventory. But I'm not that sadistic yet. And if I ever do that, it won't be in the village, that's for sure. So, and we need our casting basin. Let me go to sleep real quick. I'm sleeping because I'm trying to keep the population of zombies and skeletons down to a minimum because they're so bad. And you can actually place it beside the basin or on the other side of the basin. You can place it anywhere within the 3 blocks. So, like, if I wanted to, I could actually place it right here beside the tank if I want to. But again, like I stressed before, we don't want to do that. We want to put everything inside and then have the tank and stuff on the outside. And I'll show you later on why. Probably later on in the series, because it's going to take a little bit of work to get that done. So, we're missing just a few more things, guys. Just bear with me. So we need a smelter. I can't remember how to do the drain. Saved my life, I can't remember. Ah, okay. It's like a pair of legs. It's just like this. Alright, and we need 2 of them. Okay. So we'll just take the drains. Wherever you plan on putting a basin or your casting table, you want to drain right on top. Okay. But unfortunately, you can't do anything because there's no faucets on these things. So we need to make faucets for them. And I know it just seems like a lot, but believe me, later on in time, when you start doing it more often, it just becomes second nature. So look there, we had just enough to make 2 faucets. And we just put them on there. You don't have to hold down shift or right click or anything. Do I have any more grout? Yeah. Can we cook this? I mean, I'm not gonna waste the fire. It'd be dumb. Alright, so everything is... looks like it's working now. So the only other thing I can show you, and I'm gonna have to do it off camera because getting obsidian is gonna be difficult, is the tool forge upgrade. The tool forge is the upgraded version, or as I call it, the tier 2 version, requires your old tool station, and then it doesn't require, it just requires, okay, cool. Wow, okay, it's awesome. I just realized something too. I thought it would take obsidian. It doesn't. I just realized that oh my god! Okay, I gotta kill that. Oh, we're dead. He has 100 and some health. Oh boy. Oh my god! Wow, okay. Wow. I just realized something, that I could have built this without... Actually, I needed to finish off this, because I gotta build this too high. Because you have to have the drains actually on the same level. So, yeah. So we're gonna have to put another... excuse me, we're gonna have to put another layer here. But first things first, we need to kill these sons of bitches. Wow. Man, they just came full force there, didn't they? Alright. I hate these fucking clowns. Ugh. How do I catch this guy? He was looking at the... Oh god, this is the one with the 60 health. Got him. Ooh, he dropped a whole bunch of stuff. Ooh, he dropped a whole bunch of stuff. Sweet. Oh, shout out down there. Okay, is this done? Oh, damn. Okay, what I was going to do was use our iron ore to show you how it works, but I wasn't thinking. So we could have gotten 2 stacks of 64 versus 1, which sucks. Sucks big monkey balls. And I forgot to build the stupid bucket, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Damn it. Okay. Ugh. These infernal mobs, ridiculous. And then on top of all that, they have like a special ability? But it's part of the challenge, man. It's part of the challenge. Alright. So how many of these can we get? Oof. Not really enough. That's fine. As you can see, they're stackable. They stack on top of each other. You just hold down shift on the controller. So that way you don't right-click on it. Because you can right-click on the shift on the controller. And from pretty much any angle. See? And you can get to it. Unfortunately, we won't be able to click it from here. Which is, you know, fine. And dandy. Bucket. And I need to make the blocks. That's right. Ugh, so much to do. So little time. I'm late. For a very important date. Alright, one more. Alright, there's our 4. Oh, we missed one. Alright, there's our 4. Let me go ahead and make the bucket just in case. Don't want to run out. Yeah, 1, 2. Yeah, we got it. We got them. Alright, cool. Put that up, because I don't want to lose them. Bucket up, put that up. We'll go ahead and put that in there. I really should take most of this downstairs. I'm too lazy to go over there, though. We were building bricks. Alright, we're almost done. So, you know, as you can see, it's going to take, for a regular size... You got 4, 8, 12, 16, 24, 32, 40. Hey, what the hell am I counting? Yeah, that's right. So, you know, 3 times 4, right? 4, 8, 12, yeah. So 4, 8, 12, and 12 times 3 is... I'm sucky with math. 12 times 3 is 36. Yeah, 36. And then just basically, if you go a 3x3 for each of them, then just multiply that times 4. Or multiply that times 5. So 36 times 5. Oh, I'm bleeding. And that's how much seared brick you're going to need. If I remember straight, I may be 100% wrong. Like I said, I suck at math. I really do. I really suck at math. So, that's one of my only real weaknesses. I'm good at everything else. Kind of, per se, I guess you'd say. But I just suck at math. I don't want to do that. I don't want to fall on this. If I fall on this, I'll die. And I'll create blood. So we're going to go get some lava. I guess we could do it. Yeah, we better do it here. Because if you go outside, you're going to have to be fighting the crap out of everything else. So lava's what's going to... Jesus. What the hell? Oh, it's you. Ooh, a heart. Oh, I saw you, ghost. Oh, God. Now, you weren't here. You weren't there just a few minutes ago. Ooh, you dropped some type of gun. There's another one here. I think there is. These guys give you blindness, and they hit hard. Okay, what the hell's hitting me? What the hell hit me? Oh, there you are. Oh, you're in the ground. No wonder I could see you. Why the hell are you down here? That's dumb. You wanna die? I got him. Alright. Well, there's another ghost. Yeah, you keep jumping, buddy. Oh, bullshit. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Come on. Got him. Okay. Good God. The amount of crap that can come after you down here. It's ridiculous. I love it, though. I complain about it, but I really love it. Alright, let me get this lava real quick. Show you this, and then we're going to end the episode with, God, why did I think I need obsidian? I don't even know why I thought I needed that. I need to get that villager, too. Wherever he went. He's probably dead. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. What the shit? Oh my God, how many ghosts were down here? Wow. You know what? Oh boy. Okay, you guys have a great day. See, even with torches, they still come out. It's crazy. I'm not crazy. You're crazy. Actually, I can probably show you with the copper that we have. It's a good idea. Yeah. I'll show you with copper. Because we need to make a copper weapon. Okay, seriously? I need the corner. Oh my goodness. Alright, I need to sleep too, so the villagers don't get killed. Alright, are you gonna let me sleep? Yeah, you let me sleep. Cool. I love the sleeping bag. It's been like a lifesaver. For like, ever. So, where like, the Ender IO thermal expansion and all that requires energy, the Tigger's Construct does not. It requires lava. I'm on fire. It literally put me on fire. And it blew me up. Ugh. Okay. They don't have the same mechanics as the skeletons, though. That's the crap part. Alright. Still sees me. Damn it. Did the ninja go away? I think the ninja went away. Oh, no you don't. Why are you so strong? Come on, bro. Calm down. Oof. Calm the F down. Shit. Alright, pick up the stuff. I don't know how the gun works still. Constant strain consumes 2 energy to automatically spray. I don't get it. So like I'm supposed to double click or something? Oh! It works. But I got slowness. Oh, that's cool though. Alright, that'll be kinda cool. Ooh, but it's slow. Ooh, it gave you slow. That's interesting. Okay, so you just take your lava bucket, you just right click on it, and you can see that the lava is filling the tank up. If you right click on the controller, sometimes this GUI bugs out a little bit, but basically. Oh shit. Not again.